Sandoil is an independent oil and gas company. It's listed here in London, but has assets in Italy and in Indonesia. It's just acquired a near production gas field in Italy. We're talking now to the chief executive, Gerry Orbell. You've also recently bought 500,000 shares in the company. We'll get more on that in just a minute, but obviously you've got faith in your business. What is your strategy before we get on to this most recent acquisition?
Strategy is to focus on Italy, focus on Indonesia. We've got good people in both places, and we run it with minimal people in London, and we look to expertise on the ground. We want to learn about a country and then invest in the country. We don't use the scattergun.
Italy, this is where the most recent news has come through from. You've got this near production asset now. Obviously an exciting development for you. Tell us a little bit more about this and what it means for Sandoil.
This is an asset which has been in production for some years. In fact, it goes back 50 years, and it was shut in by another company. The government of Italy took it away. We applied to them and said, can we reopen it? And they said to us, yes. And it's got all the facets of production, gas production on site, and it didn't cost us a penny.
Why Sandoil and why not other companies? What did they say or do that led the Italian government to say, yes, you can do it? Or have you missed something, do you think?
No, I mentioned the fact that we've got expertise. We run the company with Italians in Rome on the ground, and not Brits in Rome on the ground. And there's a great rapport amongst Italians, and I think we've got that rapport and the respect of the government and other people for a small company being active and getting after it in Italy.
So what does this mean for Sandoil? What's the projection?
Well, it's the first operated opportunity. It's not a huge thing. I mean, we've had reservoir engineers look at this, and it will turn maybe $60,000 a month. That's when it shut in. That was the volume of money coming through to the company. So it's low cost, quick returns on our money, and it gives us a learning curve for other and bigger and better things.
When will investors see a return from this?
Well, we have to do an environmental study, or at least discuss with the local region of March. If they want to see the environmental study, that's a couple of months. Probably they won't, because it's a pre-existing gas field shut in. So we could probably be on site sometime in the early new year. We would have to recertify the equipment, which takes a couple of months, and connect it back up. Could see around March time money coming through.
If they do want to take this further and there is an environmental impact report negative for your company, is that going to cost a lot of money?
No, we do it in-house. It's a bench top exercise. We do them pretty regularly for everywhere. The Italians are very keen on their environment, and you have to do it all the time. So it's no great shock that we have to do it, except for the fact that this is a gas field that's already been there, and it's been there for donkey's years, really.
Does this more than offset the disappointment you had a short while ago in Italy?
Yes, it does. It's probably bigger than Marciano, but not a lot. But it's also something which is probably going to be connected quite easily to the national grid. There's a connection pipe right on site, and so we could just connect it up and make money straight away.
What about your other Italian assets?
Yeah, they're quite exciting. The Nevesa well is going to be drilled in probably the early part of 2012. That's another gas field that's been partially depleted. Altogether about 10 sands have got gas in, we know, from the original well. One of the sands was used, depleted by ENI. They decided not to go any farther. What we want to do is redrill gas. It's there, we know, so we just redrill it and put it on stream. So that's pretty exciting, and that should be a relatively low-cost thing. Other opportunities, we've got Montefano coming up, but the first one we've got is a farming one at Casa Tiberi, which means the House of Tiberius, I understand. It's a fantastic lump of land on the coast near an airport beside the city of Ancona. We're just making the well site ready for the drilling operation. You have to put cement onto the well site as a foundation, for instance, and dig bonds around the outside to stop any mess going into the countryside. And we've got a company, Italian company called Hydro Drill, which is not drilling for water, but it's drilling for oil.
Right.
They're coming on probably within the next 60 days to start the drilling operation there. It's a shallow well, so it'll be very quick, and if it's successful, it's worth a bunch of money to us. I'm looking, at the upside, looking to be around $35, $40 million.
When will we know, and how are you going to signpost this to investors?
Well, we've mentioned last Monday that we've started turning the ground there.
Mm-hmm.
We'll let them know when we start the drilling, and since it's only 2,000 feet deep, it should be a very quick result, I should think probably in 10 days. And after that, if there's rockets going up over Rome, you know what's happened.
We'll look out for those. Look, Gerry, I want to talk as well about your exposure to Indonesia, which is now quite a minor part of the business, isn't it?
Well, it's a major operation for us, but a minor impact if it's taken just as 5% equity.
Right.
We used to have a lot more equity and carried people, and it was too costly for us, to be blunt. We turned that right round and took a lower position, but they carry us now. So we've got a deal where we're going to drill two very deep, very big exploration prospects and also develop another field with gas in it already. All of this is carried free and without cost to us. And the first trouble we have is worrying where to put the money when it comes in from the gas field production.
Well, that sounds good. I understand in total you've got, what, 9 target wells, I believe, now. Is that right? It's set to be rolled out over the next year.
Yeah, well, there's 9 target wells now in Indonesia alone.
Right.
And a further 3 operations, including Rapagnano, or maybe 4 if you include Rapagnano in Italy. And in Indonesia, you mentioned that, we've got 3 wells in Java, exploratory wells. We've got 20% there. Mm-hmm. Very big prospects, but not without risk. We've got 2 very, very big operations for exploration in Kalimantan, where we've got 5%, but we're carried. And we've got a gas field called Kerendon, which is coming on stream mid-2013, mm-hmm. where we've got 5%. No worries about investment. First worry about, as I mentioned, putting the money in the bank. Mm. If the 2 big prospects in Kalimantan came in, it would be, albeit with 5%, worth maybe up to 20 million barrels equivalent, but in gas, to us.
Right.
So 5% means a lot.
Before I talk about the share price itself, I just want to very briefly ask you about the funding of all your projects. Do you have to come to the market for more funding? Where are you going to get the money from?
Everything I talked about so far is funded. Every single
fully
thing.
Funded?
Fully funded.
Right.
Money's in our pockets. We're ready to spend. In the future, of course, either we get production out of the ground, which will be returned back into further exploration and appraisal drilling, or we do come to the market. Mm. It depends how quickly the shareholders want to see investments occur. If you wait for production to occur, it might mean a pause in the activity of the business whilst we bring production on stream. They want to see continuous exploration. Maybe they will stump up with some new money.
You got quite a liquid stock, and I know the share price at the moment, 2.6 pence. In fact, you bought, as I said at the top of this interview, 500,000 shares, I believe, a couple of months ago in the company, 2.4 pence. Obviously, you've got an interest, more than an interest in the company, and obviously your strategy for you is working. And Investec, I think, has got a buy recommendation on the stock of 5 pence.
This week, yes.
Where do you go from here, without talking about the share price itself? Where do you see the value? What returns do you see for investors?
We have a lot of activity coming up, and generally with small companies, every time you spud a well, there's a bit of interest. I don't see how much more interest could be in Sound, because we've got very active shareholding,
right.
But there is generally a tick up in price on the expectation. We have a number of wells coming in the autumn and going right through to 2012, where bang, 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 one after the other. If we get a goer on one of those, I see the share price really taking off. We have been 6p earlier in the year.
Sure, absolutely. One final question, the economy, the stock market, and all this with small cap companies. How do you feel about the prospects given the economic outlook?
Well, they haven't asked me to rescue Greece yet, but I've got my ideas. In terms of fundraising, which is a big thing in small cap companies, a colleague of mine who used to work with me 20 years ago has just raised $60 million on a small cap company for exploration drilling. So that's encouraging that there is still quite a lot of interest in the sector within the institutions. In terms of whether we go up or whether we go down, because the FTSE goes up or FTSE goes down, I don't think there's much of a linkage. I think that we go down or go up for other reasons, and it's principally on activity and the impact that a large discovery would have on a small company. So the economy is one thing. Raising debt funding, if we were in that position, is hopeless. But nevertheless, I think in terms of our activities for the next 12 months, we're fully funded, the economy does what it does, and we do what we do.
Okay, all right, very interesting. Thanks for spending some time with us. Gerry Orbell there, Chief Executive of Sound Oil. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorised by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.